In this video, I'm going to show you how to simulate the current distribution of this KiCad layout. These pins here draw 10 mA, and these pins 50 mA, and the current of all these pins flows into the ground here. Okay, so let's start. Take any KiCad layout and click on File, and then on Plot. Deselect all the layers, and only select the front and bottom layer. Change the plot format to DXF. Set all the check marks and dropdowns the same way as I did. The DXF files will be stored in this subfolder. Now press plot. Let's now open LibreCad. We will use this application so that we can merge the DXF files. Press File, Import, Block. Select the first layer, place it at least one PCB distance away from the center. You will later understand why. Now also import the second layer, place it above. The DXF items now have to be exploded. Do this by first marking both PCBs, then click on Tools, Modify, and Explode. Save the DXF file and open FEMM 4.2. Create a new problem, select the current flow problem and click OK. Click File, Import DXF. The value here should be as fine as possible. If it's too big, some lines will be not connected, and you will receive a warning message. I will set it to this value. Just wait until this message disappears. This might take up to 5 minutes. Once the import is done, zoom out to see the whole PCB with this button. Make sure the multi-selection tool is activated, and then click on the rectangle selection tool. Mark this PCB and delete it via the delete key on your keyboard. Now zoom into all PCBs again. Set this pad to 0 volts as this is our ground. For this, let's create the 0 volts boundary. Simply call it ground. Change to the line segment editor. You can select a line via right click. Hold down the control key to add multiple lines to the selection. Hit the space bar to open the property window. Zoom out with this button. Now zoom into this area. I plan to inject 10 mA into these pins and 50 mA into these pins. Let's for this create the current density boundary. I created this Excel sheet to calculate the value that we have to enter into the simulation tool. It only consists of one formula and three values that we have to enter manually. The copper thickness is 35 micrometers. The width of the pad we can get by opening KiCad, then clicking on the pad and hitting E on the keyboard. The desired current is 10 mA. Copy this value and paste it. And let's create one more boundary for 50 mA. Zoom out again. The next step is to define the copper areas and the empty spaces. Select the boundary tool, let's place a boundary into every area of the PCB. I will speed up this part of the video. As you can see, I'm zooming in and out of the PCB to be able to place the boundaries correctly. Use the marking tool to mark all the boundaries at once. Now change all of them to no mesh. Let's now add copper to our project library. Now move copper to the right and click OK. Now change all the boundaries that are supposed to be copper to copper. Let's save our progress. And try to compute the mesh. The pop-up tells us that we forgot a few areas. The areas that are still not defined are marked in gray. Let's define them now. Rerun the meshing. This time the meshing was successful. To connect the vias from the top to the bottom of the PCB, we have to use the periodic boundary condition. I'm now creating at least 20 via boundaries. If more are needed, we can add more later. Let's define the first via on the bottom side. And do the same for the top side. Now let's repeat this process for all other vias on the PCB. let's start the solver. If the solver finishes without any messages, you can switch to the results view. We can now see the voltage drop across the ground plane. This menu lets you look at the current distribution. Let's change the range so we can see more details. Thank you for watching.